limitation than the other idea, the idea of communism, that there should be no individual as well. People should be equal. Just they can have their bread, that's all. As far as freedom, no freedom. You have to give up your freedom in order to eat your bread. You have to listen to the government. And the government is your father and your mother. That's what the communistic ideas tell us. And on the other hand, you can accumulate billions and billions of dollars, and no one can ask you to do anything. You do not need to pay zakah, you do not need to pay khums. These things are unnecessary. And here we find the faith of Islam. It is not against the poor people, it is not against the wealthy people. Communistic ideas are against the wealth of the individual. And you come to the faith of Islam. The faith of Islam is not against the wealth of the individual. It's not against the wealthy people. It is against what? Against one thing. It's against poverty. You can be wealthy, but you should not be poor, according to the faith of Islam. Every person should have his share on this earth. Everyone should be secure in some way. With all these supreme ideas which came from heaven, we find that the Holy Prophet Muhammad was predicting just the continuity of the Islamic rule only for 30 years. Democracy of Great Britain has already passed 300 years. Democracy or dictatorial or communistic ideas of the Soviet Union has already reached 80 years. But the ideas of Muhammad, the ideas of the Holy Quran, the Prophet was saying just it will continue for 30 years. Why? The principles of the Holy Quran are much higher than the principles of the Soviet Union and the Western democracy. They cannot be compared with the great ideas of Islam. What's the reason that rule could not continue? Could not continue even for the age of one man. Not even 60 years, not 70 years, not 50 years, just 30 years. And actually, if you realize what took place, it was just 18 years.